Well, we've got a new video, and this one is going to be all about something called negative exponents. So that's for things like this. Well, we talked a little bit about 2 to the 0, what that equals. And then we also are now going to take that one step further and say, what the heck would 2 to the negative 3 be? Well, let's kind of sneak up on it. So how we're going to do this is let's start by saying what 2 to the 3rd is, right? Okay, so 2... the third, right, is just 2 times 2 times 2, right, which is just equal to 8, right? 2 times 2 times 2 equals 8, all right? Now, 2 squared, of course, 2 times 2 equals 4. 2 to the first, well, still kind of makes sense, right? Equals 1, 2. Now, let's see what we're doing. Now, okay, so far things were kind of making sense, but now what happens? There's nothing left here, right? We keep taking away twos until there's nothing left. Well, we could think of it this way. How did we get from 8 to 4? Well, we divided by 2, didn't we? And how did we get from 4 to 2? Well, we divided by 2. Well, hey, let's do the same thing here. Let's divide by 2. Okay, well, 2 divided by 2, well, that's just equal to 1, isn't it? Hey, awesome. Well, so that to me says that 2 to the 0 power equals 1. All right, now there's sort of some logic there too when you think about it, because, you know, really when it comes right down to it, couldn't you think of this as being times 1, right? You could think of it as having a 1 in front, like 1 times this. And 1 times that, 1 times this. So really, that sort of makes sense, right? You just keep taking away a 2, and there's that 1 again, right? All right, well, that gets us to 1, but gosh, I've kind of ran out of 2s to take away. But, well, let's take a look at our pattern again, right? We kept dividing by 2, so let's do that again. I'm going to divide by 2. Well, 1 divided by 2, that's a half, isn't it? Oh, well, that kind of worked, didn't it? So I guess I'm saying then that we're going to do this. So look, I went from 3 to 2 to 1 to 0. I keep taking away 1, right? 3 minus 1 is 2, 1 minus 0, right? So 0 minus 1 gives me 2 to the negative 1, doesn't it? So look, 2 to the negative 1 equals 1/2. Now let's think of it this way. You could also think of it as being 1 over 2 to the first power, couldn't you? Right? I mean, that kind of works. Okay, so again, I'm kind of liking this pattern. Now let's do it again. All right, okay, once again, let's divide by 2. Now, you know, dividing by 2, another way of thinking about dividing by 2, that's the same thing as saying times 1/2, doesn't it? Right? Because once you get into fractions, it's a little easier to think about multiplying by fractions rather than dividing. Okay, well, then 1/2 of 1/2 is 1/4, isn't it? Right? This is 1/4. So if we go back here again, right? 3, 2, 1, 0, negative 1, negative 2. Well, that means I just decided that this is equal to 1. And actually, let me have to work from the other way, right? This is like 1 over 2 squared, isn't it? In other words, I just said this is 1 over 2 times 2, which is equal to 4. See how it's kind of all making sense here? So we've got something that sort of works. Finally, again, let's do it one last time, right? Divide by 2. We got that same pattern again, right? This is 1/8. I've got 2 to the negative 3, which is like saying 1 over 2 cubed, isn't it? Which is like 1 over 2 times 2 times 2, which is in fact an 8. It all hangs together. In other words, if you've got a negative exponent, what we're really saying is make it a fraction with that as a positive exponent on the bottom. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to generalize that a little bit, okay? So let's move this up here. Now, in general, the way the rule works is, if I put this as just a generic base, So let me just do this. I'm going to say b for base. This is a variable b, right? B to the negative n, where n is usually like an integer of some sort, is going to be equal to 1 over b to the nth power, right? So if you've got a negative exponent, whatever it is, it could be negative 3, it could be negative 572, right? You're just going to flip it over and becomes 1 over b to the n, right? Whatever this thing was becomes 1 over something to the n, right? Or another way of thinking about it, different version of it, is to say if you've got 1 over, and again, this time we're going to have this, but I'm going to make this a negative. So I'm not saying these are equal, right? I'm just saying a different situation here. 1 over b to the negative n, right? So let's say that the negative was in a denominator. And so what we could do is we can actually bring that up to the numerator again by rather being a negative n, we're going to make it just a positive n, just a positive n. Okay, now there is one requirement here, and that is that b, your base, cannot equal 0. That's the only part that doesn't work if b is 0, but other than that, everything works great, right? So, okay, so let's go ahead, you know, just really quickly, I'm just going to do a couple of really quick examples, right? So if I had 5 to the negative 2, 5 to the negative 2 is equal to 1 over 5 squared, which is equal to 1 over 25, okay? 3 to the negative 4, 3 to the negative 4 is 1 over 3 to the 4th. Which turns out that's 1 over 3 times 3 times 3 times 3, which is equal to 1 over, right, 3 and 3, that's 9s, so that's a 1 over 81, okay? All right, so that's just some examples of what we're doing here. All right, so now let's take a look at just some examples that you might run into in our upcoming homework, okay? So what you might see is something like this. Right, 1 over 286, 1 over 28 to the 6th power. Now, in that case, I've got a positive exponent in the denominator, right? Now, let's look at some of the options they've given us. Now, one thing that we just want to really keep in mind is that these positive and negatives we're talking about, look how that did not change the fact that the whole unit's positive or negative, right? And this is what we have to be very careful of. This is not saying I've got like a negative value. What I'm saying is, what it's really saying is, do the inverse of taking it to the third power. In other words, this is less like saying I've got negative numbers, as I'm saying, do the inverse of what taking something to the third is. Well, it's the inverse of taking it to the third is flipping it over and taking it to the third. In other words, notice how it's not like this is a negative number here, right? The exponent's negative. Again, it doesn't mean make it negative. So look right off the bat, right? See how these three became negatives? Those just can't be right. I'm quite certain of that. Well, this one could be because it's a positive, but something funny is going on with the exponent. So let's just go back and look here. I've got 1 over 28 to the 6th. Now, I'd like to get this up into the exponent. So into the numerator. So if I just flip it, this becomes 28. I don't want it as a fraction anymore. To do that, I had to make that a negative 6. And so, yeah, that one doesn't work, right? We, you know, don't like this negative sign, so that guy's no good. I don't like that minus sign, no good. Now this one could be it because negative and negative is positive, but look, that becomes just 28 to the 6th power. Well, that doesn't work. So the only one that makes sense is this one here, 28 to the negative 6th, okay? All right, let's take a look at some more problems here. Now, you're going to get some problems that says write the expression as a whole number with a negative exponent, right? So this is what's important. Now I want a negative exponent, and look at this, do not evaluate. Right? This is a crazy big number. I'm not expecting you to put this in your calculator. If you did, it would like spit it out at you, give you a big error statement. So all we're looking for here is just to say, well, negative exponent. I don't like positive 460. Well, the way to make that negative is to flip them upside down. So now it's going to be 372 to the negative 460 power. Okay, that's all you got to do. All right, okay, let's look at another one. Now, evaluate, write your answer as a fraction. Oh, look, this time it said evaluate. That means find the value, right? Well, hey, we just did that one a second ago, didn't we, right? Evaluate means find the value. So yes, I would do this step, right? 2 to the -3, I'd say, look, 2 to the -3, okay? And I'm gonna say that's equal to 1/2 cubed. But I'm not done because it said evaluate. So evaluate means do as much as you can in the calculations. Oh, well, that's 2 times 2 times 2. That's 1/8. So in this case, your answer would be actually 1/8 because it said evaluate. Here, did not, the one above, do not evaluate, right? Okay, so finally, let's do one more here. Now let's take a little bit, what happens when we start to have fractions? Now, with fractions, it turns out we can just flip the fraction. So again, this is one of these evaluate statements. Look, so evaluate, I wanna do as much as I can to get, find out what the number is. So I'm gonna keep going as far as I can. Now, what this turns out to be is this. 1/2 of -3 is the same thing as 2/1/3, right? In other words, I didn't like it as a negative. To make it a positive, I flip the fraction inside. And then that just becomes 2 times 2 times 2, which is 8, okay? Another one real quick, okay? Let's say I had something like, this one's gonna have to stay as a fraction though, right? Let's say I had 2/3 to the -4. 2/3 to the -4. Now again, I'm not crazy about the -4, so I'm gonna flip it. So this becomes 3/2 to the 4th, right? It was a negative. I said, do the inverse, make it positive, which means 2/3 became 3/2. Well, this is just 3 to the 4th, and this is 2 to the 4th. Well, 3 to the 4th, right? We did that one recently, but just a quick reminder, right? 3 times 3 times 3 times 3. 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, right? 3 times 3, 9, 3 times 3, 9. So that means this is 81 over, right? 2 times 2, 4, another 4, 16, okay? So that's what it would be as just a fraction. We could try to divide it into it as well if you wanted. So it really depends though, they said just as a fraction, then we could stop there because you can't simplify this any further by dividing it into it. So anyway, those are the examples we're going to do today, and we will talk to you guys at the next video.